After discussing the various molecular biology of the tumor or molecular pathogenesis of the tumor or molecular basis of carcinogenesis, I am proceeding to next class today, that is a spread of tumor, grading and staging of the tumor, tumor immunology and effects of the tumor on the host. A spread of the tumor. The spread of the tumors by local invasion or direct spread, and in the benign tumors, most benign tumors are encapsulated or circumscribed mass and that expand and push aside the surrounding normal tissue without actually invading, infiltrating or metastasizing. Malignant tumors, on the other hand, enlarge by expansion, and some well-differentiated tumors may be partially encapsulated, as well as follicular carcinoma, thyroid. But characteristically, they are distinguished from benign tumors by invasion, infiltration, destruction of the surrounding tissue, besides a spread to distant sites or metastasis. The benign tumors, the mode of rapid growth and the mode of growth is by expansile, pushing aside the surrounding tissue. Whereas malignant tissue, rate of growth is rapid and it is initially expansile, but later on there is invasion, infiltration into the surrounding tissue and destruction of the surrounding tissue, and besides sometimes a spread to distant sites or which is called metastasis. The spread of the tumors occur by local or direct spread, direct invasion of the contiguous organ, lymphatic spread, hematogenous spread, spread along body cavities or natural passage. The mechanism or biology of local invasion or metastasis, aggressive, I have discussed in the molecular biology class also. So mechanism or biology of the local invasion or metastasis is aggressive clonal proliferation and angiogenesis, tumor cell loosening, tumor cell extracellular matrix interaction, degradation of extracellular matrix, then entry of tumor cells into the capillary lumen by autocrine motility factors and change cleavage products of the matrix components formed following degradation of the extracellular matrix, then thrombus formation, then extravasation of the tumor cells from the distant lodging, and then survival and growth of the metastatic deposit, and that is by angiogenesis and growth factors, facilitated by growth factors, survival and growth of metastatic deposit facilitated by growth factors like platelet derived growth factors, fibroblast growth factors, transforming growth factors beta and vascular endothelial growth factors. Then invasion or metastasis, just the repetition of the molecular biology, aggressive clonal proliferation, then tumor cell loosening, adhesion of the tumor cells, degradation of extracellular matrix, transformation, then growth, basement membrane invasion, local invasion, then angiogenesis, then intravasation, then embolization, that is circulating tumor cells, then adhesions, then extravasation or angiogenesis, micrometastasis and colonization, that is metastatic growth. Then metastasis or distant spread. Metastasis or distant spread is a spread of the tumor to distant sites as secondary tumor or mass without continuity from the primary sites. Metastasis or distant spread is a spread of the tumor or to distant sites as secondary tumors or mass without continuity from the primary sites. Defined as the development of secondary implants, metastasis discontinuous with the primary tumor in remote tissue. Benign tumors do not metastasize. Exceptions are gliomas of the central nervous system and basal cell carcinoma. Approximately 30% of the newly diagnosed patients with the solid tumors present with clinically evident metastasis. An additional 20% occult metastasis at the time of the diagnosis. So metastasis is a spread of the tumor to the distant sites as secondary tumors or mass without continuity from the primary sites. Now, preferential metastatic sites, primary tumor and common metastatic site, that is distant sites, breast adenocarcinoma metastasize to distant site, bone, brain and adrenal. Prostate adenocarcinoma metastasize to bone, then lung small cell carcinoma metastasize to bone, brain and liver. A skin cutaneous melanoma metastasize to brain, liver and bowel. Thyroid adenocarcinoma metastasize to bone. Then clear cell carcinoma of the kidney metastasized to bone, liver and thyroid, and testis carcinoma metastasized to liver. Similarly, bladder carcinoma metastasized to brain and neuroblastoma metastasized to liver and adrenals. These are the common sites of metastasis of the primary tumor I have discussed. Then pathways of the metastasis. Seeding body cavities like peritoneum, pleura and meninges. Lymphatic spread, that is proximal lymph nodes, are often the first place to look for metastasis. This is the end of TNM staging. Second is lymphatic spread. First is seeding body cavities, peritoneum, pleura or meninges. Second is lymphatic spread to the regional lymph nodes. Then hematogenous spread by blood-borne metastasis to the liver, lungs, brain and bone. GI tumors often metastasize, often end up here due to portal metastasize via the portal system. Similarly, by venous circulation of the systematic venous circulation drains to lung capillary bed. Metastasis is a spread of the tumor from one organ or part to another, non-adjacent or non-contiguous organ or part. The definition is a spread of the tumor, metastasis is a spread of the tumor cells or cancers from one organ or part to another non-contiguous or non-adjacent organ or part. Roots of metastasis, cancer is spread to distant site by lymphatic spread, hematogenous spread and spread through body cavities or natural passages. Then lymphatic spread, carcinoma metastasized by lymphatic root while sarcoma favor hematogenous route. Lymphatic spread occurs by lymphatic permeation and lymphatic emboli. Lymphatic permeation, walls of the lymphatics are readily invaded by cancer cells. A lymphatic emboli, tumor detached to form emboli so as to be carried along the lymph to the next draining lymph nodes. That is in the form of emboli, lymphatic emboli or permeation adjacent lymph node. Then lymphatic spread, I have told you lymphatic permeation and lymphatic emboli, but sometimes lymphatic metastasis do not develop first to the lymph node nearest to the tumor because venous lymphatic anastomosis or due to obliteration of the lymphatics by inflammation or radiation and is called a skip metastasis. Other due to obstruction of the lymphatic by tumors, the lymph flow is distributed and tumor cells spread against the flow of the lymph called retrograde metastasis or at unusual site. Metastasis of carcinoma prostate to the supraclavicular lymph node. Barco lymph nodes is the nodal metastasis preferably to supraclavicular lymph node from cancer of the abdominal organs like carcinoma stomach, colon and gallbladder and carcinoma testis also, testicular tumors also, which is Barco lymph node. Barco node is left supraclavicular lymph node, and if it is palpable, it is called in the surgery Treiser sign. Treiser sign is present. So this is the lymphatic spread. So lymphatic channel is shown here. Lymphatic channel is shown here. Along the lymphatics, the lymph node spread has occurred. This is the normal tissue, here the metastatic tissue. The lung metastasis to regional lymph nodes, lung metastasis. Then breast cancer metastasized to axilla, nodal metastasis to axillary lymph node. Breast tissue metastasized to axillary lymph node. Whereas lung tissue metastasized to paratracheal or hilar lymph nodes. And in the lymph nodes, here there is metastatic in the subcapsular space, there is metastatic deposit. So axillary nodes involved by carcinoma, breast, hilar and paratracheal lymph nodes involved by bronchogenic carcinoma, lymphatic spread begins by lodgement of tumor cells in supraclavicular lymph node via efferent lymphatics entering into the convex surface of the lymph node. There is the lymph node metastasis, here it is the normal lymph node and here it is the cancer cell. As I have told you, there is plenty of eosinophilia, cytoplasm is eosinophilic and so there is plenty of eosinophilic tumor cells or neoplastic or cancer cells and it is thick blue lymph nodes, normal cells, and here it is the cancer cells. Hematogenous spread, it is a common route for sarcoma, but certain carcinoma also frequently metastasize by the lymph node. Example, liver, lungs, brains, bone, kidney, adrenals. Few organs such as spleen, heart, skeletal muscles do not allow tumor metastasis to grow due to anatomical consideration. Hematogenous spread occurs through systematic veins, portal veins drain, pulmonary veins, arterial spread and retrograde spread of the thyroid and prostate. So hematogenous spread is common and the common sites of hematogenous spreads are liver, lungs, brain, bone, kidney and adrenals. And sarcoma is the most common tumors for spreading via the hematogenous route. Hematogenous spread via the portal vein, the spread to liver of the colorectal or gastric carcinoma spread to liver. Here the spread to lungs, hematogenous route, then spread to the brain, then spread to the bones and spread to the adrenals. Here spread from spread to liver from carcinoma colon via portal vein or bronchogenic carcinoma or breast carcinoma. Here this is the tumor that is spread to liver by the portal vein from the bronchogenic carcinoma, breast carcinoma or colorectal carcinoma. There is secondary deposits, nodular deposits, extensive nodular deposits in case of secondaries in the liver from the primary at the kidney or via portal veins, colonic carcinoma, gastric carcinoma, etc. Spread to bone from bronchial carcinoma, breast carcinoma, thyroid carcinoma, renal cell carcinoma, produce dense osteosclerotic mass and prostatic carcinoma also. Spread to brain and meninges from bronchogenic carcinoma, breast carcinoma, testicular carcinoma, then malignant melanoma, spread to brain and meninges. Then spread along the natural body cavities and natural passage, transilomic spread or spread through the serosal cavity, that is peritoneal cavity involved most often by pleural and pericardial cavities like carcinoma spread, stomach spread into both ovaries, Krukenberg tumor, spread of carcinoma stomach to the both ovaries. Carcinoma is spreading to entire peritoneal cavity without infiltrating the underlying organs. Pseudomyxoma peritonei is the gelatinous coating of the peritoneum from mucin secreting carcinoma or appendix. Carcinoma bronchus or breast seeding to the pleura and pericardium. Spread through epithelium lined surfaces. Fallopian tube from the endometrium to the ovaries and vice versa. Through the bronchus into the alveoli. Through the ureter from the kidney into the lower urinary tract. So along the epithelial lined surface spread occurs. Spread via the CSF produce metastasis to distant central nervous system. Then implantation, inoculation. Rarely spread by implantation by surgeon scalpel, needles, sutures or may be implanted by direct contact such as transfer of the cancer of the lower lip to the opposing upper lip called kissing tumor. Then clinical stage and grade. A stage and grade determines a stage reflects extent, clinical extent of the spread of the tumor. Grading reflects its histological subtype, that is differentiation of the tumor. Staging is a spread of tumor and grading is differentiation of the tumor. Of the two, staging is primary indicator of prognosis. Grade 1 grading has been variously graded. Grade 1 is well differentiated or highly differentiated tumor, which is low grade. Grade 2 is moderately differentiated tumor. Grade 3 is poorly differentiated tumor. And grade 4 is undifferentiated tumor or anaplastic tumor, which is high grade of malignancy. So this grading shows differentiation, degree of differentiation of the tumors. And high, low grade, moderately grade, poorly grade, and high grade are anaplastic or undifferentiated. Whereas well or highly differentiated tumors are of low grade of malignancy. Then broadest grading in squamous cell carcinoma, grade 1, well differentiated, less than 25% cells are anaplastic. Then grade 2, moderately differentiated, 25 to 50% anaplastic cells. Grade 3, moderately differentiated, 50 to 70% anaplastic cells. Grade 4, poorly differentiated or anaplastic cells, more than 75% anaplastic cells. The another grading is Wierens grading, grade 1, 1 to 2 abnormal mitosis per high power field. Grade 2, 3 to 5 abnormal mitosis per.
Thing about the Wierens grading, the grading I have told you that degree of differentiation. So grading, Wierens grading consists of grade 1, 1 to 2 abnormal mitosis per high power field, grade 2, 3 to 5 abnormal mitosis per high power field, and grade 3, 6 or more than 6 abnormal mitosis per high power field. Grading of the soft tissue tumors, two grade systems as low grade or high grade, three grade system, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3 as low, intermediate and highly high grade tumors. And four grade system are grade 1, grade 2, grade 3 and grade 4. And these grading of soft tissue tumors are tumor differentiation or degree of cytological atypia and mitotic count and tumor necrosis. Histopathological grading, GX, grades of differentiation cannot be assessed. G1, well differentiated tumor, G2, moderately differentiated tumor, G3, poorly differentiated tumor, and G4, undifferentiated tumor. Grade 3 and 4 can be combined in some circumstances as grade 3, 4, poorly differentiated tumors. Then clinical stages of cancer spread, stage 1 confined to organ of origin, stage 2 locally invasive, stage 3 spread to lymph nodes, stage 4 spread to distant sites. So, and carcinoma in situ, that is confined to cells, so this is a special case. Stage 1, staging is spread of tumor, and grading is differentiation of tumor. Staging is spread of tumor, stage 1 confined to organ of origin, stage 2 locally invasive, stage 3 spread to lymph nodes, stage 4 spread to distant sites. Staging, TNM staging, tumor node metastasis system. The tumor size of the tumors in centimeters is the tumor. Involvement of lymph node is N, and presence or absence of distant metastasis denoted by M. So tumor T, lymph nodes N, and metastasis denoted by M. So these are the various, these are the TNM staging system. And the TX stands for no information available on primary tumor. T0, no evidence of primary tumor. TIS, carcinoma in situ at primary site. T1, tumor less than 2 cm. T2, tumor of 2 to 4 cm in diameter. And T3, tumor greater than 4 cm. And T4, tumor has invaded to adjacent structure. Lymph node NX, not accessible. N0, no clinically positive lymph node, not palpable. N1, single clinically positive ipsilateral lymph node less than 3 cm. N2, single clinically positive ipsilateral lymph nodes 3 to 6 centimeters, or multiple ipsilateral lymph nodes with at least less than 6 cm, or bilateral or contralateral lymph nodes with none greater than 6 cm. N3, nodes or nodes greater than 6 cm. Then MX, distant metastasis not accessible, M0, no distant metastasis, and M3, distant metastasis is present. Then TNM equivalency of American Joint System of Cancer Staging, American Joint Committee on Cancer Staging, AJCC staging system, American Joint Committee on Cancer Staging. Stage 0,
tumor in situ, N0, M0. Stage 1, T1, N0, M0. Stage 2, T2, N0, M0. Stage 3, T3, N0, M0. Or T1, N1, M0. T2, N1 or M0. T3, N1 or M0. Stage 4, T4, N0, M0. T4, N1, M0. Or any T, N2 or M0. Or any T, N3 or M0. Or any T, any N or M1 with metastasis. This is the staging of the provided by American Joint Committee on Cancer Staging. Then Akin's Enig staging of the soft tissue tumor. This is accepted by most oncologists based on the grade and location of the tumor agenda. According to tumor location, T1 intracompartmental and T2 extracompartmental. According to tumor grade, G1 low grade and G2 high grade. According to a stage of the tumor varies from stage 1 to 3. Stage 1, G1 and T1 to T2 tumors, but no metastasis. Stage 2, G2, T1 to T2 tumors, but without metastasis. Stage 3, T1 or G2, G1 or G2, T1 or T2, but with metastasis. This is commonly implied in soft tissue tumors. Ready. Residual tumor classification. The residual tumor classification is Rx, presence of residual tumor not accessible, R0 no residual tumor, R1 microscopic residual tumor, and R2 microscopic residual tumor. This is about the dysplasia. Normal, here it is normal basal cell of the basement membrane, basal membrane. Here stage 1 low grade, the tumor is here. Stage 2, carcinoma in situ, here it is, or mild dysplasia, tumor is here. In C2, the tumor is up to middle layer. And in C3 or CIN3, severe dysplasia, tumor up to whole layer, escomous epithelium, whole cervical epithelium is covered. This is carcinoma in situ. Stage 3, severe dysplasia is carcinoma in situ. And this is invasive carcinoma, that is cancer cell has invaded the basement membrane. Basement membrane, this has invaded the basement membrane. Then tumor immunology, evidence of tumor immunology is a spontaneous regression occurs in malignant melanoma, Burkitt's lymphoma, clear cell carcinoma of the kidney, then neuroblastoma, choriocarcinoma. So a spontaneous regression of the tumor suggests there is tumor immunity is also involved. Regression of metastasis after removal of primary tumor in renal cell carcinoma. Then infiltration of the tumors by lymphocytes and macrophages, melanoma and breast cell carcinoma, indicating there is immunological response of the tumor by infiltration of lymphocytes and macrophages. Then lymphocytic proliferation in the draining lymph nodes. Then higher incidence of cancer after immunotherapy. Then immunosuppression, the immunodeficiency, aging. So higher incidence of cancer after immunosuppression or immunodeficiency like AIDS or aging. Cancer immunity cycle, this is not so much important. Then host response against tumor immunology. Certain cancers evolve significant lymphocytic infiltrate. Cancer may spontaneously regress, as I have told you, in malignant melanoma, then choriocarcinoma, neuroblastoma, and etc. Then existence of immune surveillance also indicates. Then unusual primary or secondary tumors in the spleen due to ability to destroy growth and proliferation of the tumor, suggesting there is tumor immunology is acting. Tumors, antigen are tumor-specific antigen and tumor-associated antigens. Tumor-associated antigen and tumor-specific antigen. Tumor antigens, currently tumor antigens are classified as oncoproteins from mutated oncogens like RAS, B-cell lymphoma, RABL and CDK4. Protein products of the tumor suppressor genes like mutated protein P53 or B-catenin.
And overexpressed cellular proteins in melanoma, the tumor antigen is a structurally normal melanocyte specific protein tyrosinase, which is overexpressed. Abnormally expressed cellular protein like MAGE, that is melanoma associated antigen. And tumor antigen from viral mucoprotein, viral oncoprotein, that is viral oncoprotein of hepatitis, human papilloma virus E6 and E7 in cervical cancers, and EBNA proteins in Epstein-Barr virus, Burkitt lymphoma. Tumor antigen from randomly mutated genes. Tumor antigens from randomly mutated genes are mutated cells, elaborate proteins, protein products by cytotoxic lymphocytes. Cell-specific differentiation antigen, various CD markers for various subtypes of lymphomas, prostate-specific antigen in carcinoma prostate. Oncofetal antigens like carcinoma embryonic antigen in colonic carcinoma, gastric carcinoma, alpha-fetoprotein in liver cancer, pancreatic oncofetal antigen PAO in pancreatic cancer. Abnormal cell surface molecules, they may be changed blood group antigen or abnormally expressed mucin in ovarian carcinoma like CA125, in breast carcinoma, NUP1. Anti-tumor immune response. Anti-tumor immune response occurs through cell-mediated mechanism mainly and rarely, very less, humoral mechanism, antibody-mediated. So amongst the cell-mediated immune response are in tumors are specifically sensitized cytotoxic T lymphocytes. CTL, CD8 cells are directly cytotoxic to target cells. Natural killer cells are lymphocytes which after activation by interleukin-2 destroy tumor cells. Without sensitization, either directly or through antibody-dependent cell-mediated cytotoxicity, ADCP. Macrophages are activated by interferon, secreted by T cells and NK cells, therefore close collaboration with the two subpopulation of lymphocytes and macrophages. Humoral mechanism, there is no anti-tumor humoral antibody. Active, but in vitro, humoral antibodies may kill the tumor cells by complement activation or by antibody-dependent cytotoxicity. Cancer chemotherapy, no specific stimulation, non-specific stimulation of host immune response, specific stimulation of the immune system. Current status of immunotherapy is focused on the following three main approach: cellular immunotherapy, cytokine therapy, and monoclonal antibodies therapy. Effects of tumor on the host. Effects of the tumor on the host, local effect like compression, mechanical obstruction, tissue destruction, infarction, ulceration, and hemorrhages. Then systematic manifestations, generalized effect of the cancer include cancer cachexia, fever, tumor lysis syndrome, and paraneoplastic syndrome. Cancer cachexia, fever, tumor lysis syndrome. This is condition caused by extensive destruction of a large number of rapidly proliferating tumor cells and is more common in cases of lymphoma and leukemia. Characterized by hyperuricemia, hyperuricemia, hyperkalemia, hyperphosphatemia, hypocalcemia, which may result in acidosis and renal failure. Paraneoplastic syndrome are a group of conditions developing in patients with advanced cancer which are neither explained by direct or distant spread of the tumor nor by unusual hormonal aberration by the tissue of origin of the tumor. Paraneoplastic syndromes are defined as biological effects of the tumor. Symptom complex of tumors refers to a production of hormones, polypeptides or antigens by tissue, both endocrine and non-endocrine, other than the primary tissues known to produce them. Then small tumors can produce devastating remote effect. Ectopic hormone production or ectopic endocrine syndrome or ectopic hormone production or endocrinopathies. Endocrinopathy is production of the hormones by tissues, both endocrine and non-endocrine, other than the primary tissues known to produce them. This definition has been taken from Harrison Medicine, or the functional activity related to endocrinopathies by cancer cells of non-endocrine origin is called ectopic hormone production syndrome, or frequently encountered in paraneoplastic syndrome. Then paraneoplastic syndrome, endocrine syndrome, hypercalcemia, Cushing syndrome, polycythemia, hypoglycemia, neuromyopathic syndrome, peripheral neuropathy, cortical cerebral degeneration, myasthenia gravis, polymyositis. Effects on osseous joints and soft tissue, hypertrophic pulmonary osteodystrophy, clubbing of the fingers. Hematologic and vascular syndrome, venous thrombosis, Sturge's phenomenon, non-bacterial thrombotic endocarditis, disseminated intravascular coagulation, leukemia reaction and non-normocytic normochromic anemia occurring in advanced cancer. And GIT disturbance, malabsorption, hypoalbuminemia. Renal syndrome, renal vein thrombosis and systemic amyloidosis. Cutaneous syndrome, acanthosis nigricans, seborrheic dermatitis, exfoliative dermatitis. And amyloidosis, primary amyloidosis in cancer or cancer. Or in inflammation, I have told in the... Then, and this clinical syndrome, endocrinopathies are Cushing syndrome, syndrome of antidiuretic hormone, hypercalcemia, hypoglycemia, polycythemia, nerve and muscle syndrome, and myasthenia. Disorders of the central and peripheral nervous system. Acanthosis nigricans, gastric carcinoma, lung carcinoma, dermatomyositis, bronchogenic carcinoma, breast carcinoma, osseous, articular, and soft tissue tumors. Then hypertrophic osteodystrophy and clubbing of the fingers in bronchogenic carcinoma and thymic neoplasm, vascular and hematologic abnormality like venous thrombosis, pancreatic carcinoma, bronchogenic carcinoma. Then disseminated intravascular coagulation in acute promyelocytic leukemia and prostatic carcinoma. Then non-bacterial thrombotic endocarditis in advanced cancers. Then renal cell aplasia, thymic neoplasm and nephrotic syndrome in various cancers. Hypercalcemia, hyponatremia, polycythemia, trozes, hypoglycemia. These are the ectopic hormone production. This has been taken from your Harsmohan textbook of pathology, endocrine system, hypercalcemia, Cushing syndrome, inappropriate ADH, antidiuretic hormone, hypoglycemia, carcinoid syndrome, and polycythemia. Neuromuscular, myasthenia gravis, and neuromuscular disorders. Osseous, hypertrophic osteoarthropathy, and clubbing of the fingers. Then hematologic thrombophlebitis, non-bacterial endocarditis, disseminated intravascular coagulation, normocytic, normochromic anemia, and thymoma. Gastrointestinal syndrome, malabsorption, lymphoma of a small bowel. Renal syndrome, nephrotic syndrome, advanced cancers. Then cutaneous syndrome, acanthosis nigricans, seborrheic dermatitis, exfoliative dermatitis in lymphoma. Amyloidosis, primary, multiple myeloma, secondary, kidney, lymphoma, and solid tumor. This has been taken from the paraneoplastic, that is Robin's textbook. Seven danger signs of cancer are caution. C, caution. This is mnemonic caution. Change in bowel habit or bladder habit. These are the danger signals of signs of cancer. Change in bowel habit or bladder habit. A sore that does not heal. Unusual bleeding or discharge. Thickening of the lump. Indigestion or difficulty in swallowing. Obvious change in the wart or mole. Nagging cough or hoarseness of voice. Thank you. This is about the various your spread of the tumor, staging, then tumor immunology, and effects of the tumor, local and remote effect. Sometimes note is asked on the paraneoplastic syndrome or tumor lysis syndrome. This is all about the your spread of the tumor, then tumor staging and grading of the tumor. Then tumor immunology, where various tumor antigens and anti-tumor immunity, and lastly effects of the tumor on the host, local compression, obstruction, hemorrhage, necrosis, and remote effect, cancer, cachexia, then tumor lysis syndrome and fever, and tumor lysis syndrome and paraneoplastic syndrome. Thank you.